Hello and welcome to the channel. My name is Jello and this is my review of Cat Lateral Damage Remeowstered on the Nintendo Switch. But before we begin, thank you so much to my new subs this week. And if you're new here, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet. And don't forget to hit that notification bell so you don't miss out whenever a new video drops. Now share this video with a friend on your social media platform of choice. Thank you to the good folks at MonecoWare for providing me with a review copy. Now with all of that said, here is my review of Cat Lateral Damage Remeowstered on the Nintendo Switch. Let's get meowing! Cat Lateral Damage is a unique first-person game, unique in a sense because you play as a cat that is always up to nothing good. Now, the objective of the game is a simple one, and that is to knock down as many things inside the house onto the floor as you can before your energy runs out. Because of this premise, Cat Lateral Damage has been described as the premier first-person destructive house cat simulator, and that description pretty much fits the game. This game first appeared earlier on PC and PlayStation 4, and it came out at around March of 2016, I believe, for PS4, and even way back on the PC in 2015. And now the devs have made this remeowstered version and released it onto the Switch. Now the game has three modes, two of which are locked when starting up a new game, but then you can easily unlock these as you play through the game. Now these modes are goals, where you need to meet certain topple goals before your energy runs out in order to unlock new levels. If you begin to run low on energy, you can run to the nearest sleeping spot where your cat can take a cat nap to recharge a bit of energy and then continue in thrashing the place. Then there's procedural mode, which is the same as goals, but as you would guess, with procedurally generated areas to keep things feeling fresh. And there is also a litter box mode where you can play the game with no restrictions whatsoever or worrying about your energy bar depleting before you can accomplish as much destruction as you set out to deliver. As you start off the game, you need to go through the mandatory game tutorial to familiarize you on how to be an effectively destructive feline. It controls the same way as any first-person game, with the jump button mapped to B and controlling the cat's front paws with the shoulder buttons. Now, as mentioned, the main objective, regardless of what mode you choose to play, is to topple as many things onto the floor, leaving no items standing. Now, doing so will allow you to pick up stars. Stars are the currency that you will use to unlock new perks, which basically improve your cat in terms of energy, movement speed, jumping height, and swatting strength. While playing the game, you can also obtain cat photos that, if you collect enough, will allow you to unlock more cats to use in future runs. Now, each cat has its own stats, revolving around the mentioned upgradable perks, which makes using some cats have their own advantages or disadvantages over using other cats. This game also has a collection section where you can take a look at the cat photos that you have collected so far. You can also check out your game records, where you can see your total playtime, level completion, unique objects toppled, number of photos found, and the list goes on. This section will definitely scratch that itch for delving into game stats. And last part of the collection section shows you all of the objects that you have toppled so far. And this is a lot of items that you can collect for the completionists out there. The graphics of this game are bright and colorful for the most part, making each area look different from the other. I did notice a bit of pop-up in bigger levels though, but nothing really deal-breaking. This game runs smoothly on the Switch. I have not experienced any slowdown during my time playing it, at least nothing that I can remember. I did have fun playing Cat Lateral Damage for this review, and it actually came as a pleasant surprise to me. I came into this game thinking toppling objects and thrashing the house can only be satisfying to a certain extent, and then I kinda expected it to get stale as you keep going and doing the same thing. But like I said, I was pleasantly surprised as I found myself doing one more run and just another run, you know, just to find that last item on the list and send it crashing to the floor. Now the devs did a great job in keeping the game feeling fresh even though, you know, you go through repeated runs. And also, destroying stuff in game can be really satisfying, especially when you discover a new unique item Or when you just want to trash your owner's gaming PC and send it crashing to the floor. So, does trashing stuff sound interesting to you? Or do you love cats and the antics that these furry little felines do? Then that would definitely be enough reason for you to check out this game. Now, what do you think of this game so far? Because that's it for me. Tell me what you think of the game in the comment section down below. Don't forget to leave a like on your way out and do subscribe if you enjoyed this video. Enjoy the rest of the gameplay and I'll see you in the next review.
Thank you.